Alright, welcome back, folks. For me, it's been a few days since I completed Island 3, but this is a new session, and we're gonna try out Island 4, right? So, looks like we can't put it off any longer. We do have to fight the Burrowers and the Blobbers. Two enemies that definitely constrain my movements quite a bit. Regeneration could also be a bit of an issue with all these high-health alpha enemies lying around, but, you know, could be a lot worse. We already dealt with armor and explosions. Those are out of the way. So as far as, like, imminent threats to the grid, regeneration isn't so bad. It just means that more enemies will be alive for later, which, certainly is bad. But, hey, at least regen and the blob don't really mix, so there is that. Just to remind myself where we are. Okay, just the Sidewinder fist fully upgraded. Heavy rocket fully upgraded. Oh, yeah, we gotta take that out for a spin. And, the rock accelerator and boosters. Okay, and Ghana, if we decide we need him. Otherwise, he's just a regular old pilot. But, hey, regular old pilots can get a lot done. Especially compared to the, AI. Alright, let's see. Probably gonna take this one out. Air support and killing seven enemies mixes pretty well. Blocking Vex spawning, this is not a great map to do that on. We could probably do that if we really have to, but I think I prefer this one, right? Yeah, this one's relatively well open. I think we can get this one done. Okay. Could be a lot worse, honestly. Two Alpha Hornets I'm not happy about, but at least they're low enough health that we can just kill them in one hit with our Prime. So, and we can maybe make use of the heavy rocket to kill the Burrower. That is another nice thing about Burrowers, is you don't get too many of them per map, so only two per mission, and we have two rockets, so that seems like an obvious pairing, but we'll see how it turns out. Alright, Burrower did not take the bait. We do get the, we do get you to, the regeneration sign, we'll at least get killed, we'll get one round of regeneration before the environment kills it. Interesting. Alright, hopefully that won't be necessary. Okay. This Alpha Hornet is wasting its turn, so we don't have to, do anything about it if we don't want to, but I'd certainly like to at least do a little bit of damage to it. Yeah, it's pretty tempting to just go ahead and use the rocket here, just as a way of, getting that done. So how much damage do you do? You do three. Oh, three and fire, interesting. Okay, so that's an idea. So if we boulder this, it will die, even if we push it somewhere else. So I'm thinking boulder this, rocket this, and, we won't be able... That leaves nobody available to actually... Because you can't attack this because of the pinch formation. So, does that mean instead we want to rocket this instead? So, you go here and rocket that. Boulder does this, and then we punch this for four. So, this will regenerate to two. But it'll at least it'll be at two. So, it'll be killed next time we hit it. And both of these will be dead. We'll have used one of our rockets, but it'll be for pretty good purpose, I'd say. Yeah, that definitely seems like that'll take control of the field pretty well, so I think it's worth it. So for that, we'll want to do this. Don't have to worry about which direction we're pushing this, because it's stable, so we can just hit it from any direction. And then, where do I want you to be? Probably... I think right here is fine. Well, if we get a blobber, we haven't seen a blobber yet, so one's going to come up. If that's the case, we probably want it to shoot somewhere nice. And right now, its best shots would be, like, here and here. So if I go down here, it's gonna go here or here. And neither of them are really good for, like, the Hermes engines is what I'm kind of hoping for. Ultimately, I don't think it really matters too much. I don't think we can really make it that good so all things being equal, probably down here. Just sweating the placement, perhaps a little bit too much, but we'll be okay. Alright, there's the Blobber, like I thought. 2 HP Burrower. Steals that spot, so the Blob goes there. And what direction is everybody in? Okay, looks like we could get another 2-for-1 here with the rocket. Like, you actually have 5 moves. You can make it all the way down here, rocket the Hornet, shove that over there, and then that leaves you free to punch this and, well, you have 4 movements. So ideally, I guess what I want is somebody gets rid of the Alpha Burrower, and then you have 4 moves to go all the way down here and punch the Blobber. And then you can rocket this, which takes care of you and the Blob. So that actually clears the board. I think we can do that, and then that leaves us with 3 more enemies. Which seems pretty good. I like the way that that all works out. So, let's do that then. So let's do that in the right order. This is going to blow up on these squares, so we can't stand, can't put you right here, so instead you'll have to be right here. But that's fine. You've got boosters, so even if you get webbed, you should be okay. So you do this first. Doesn't shove backwards, because it's the boulder, instead of a different artillery. You can make it all the way over here, and punch to the left. And then you can rocket. So we did kind of spend our rockets a bit early, but hey, we had 2 very smooth turns as a result of it. And I think that means we'll be able to handle this last turn pretty well, even if we get like a Alpha Hornet right here or something. Alright, that's a fine place for you to be. That's a little bit less so, but we can still reach you, so it should be okay. Yeah, so now you're down to your Hermes engines, but that's fine, mostly. The easiest place to push you is actually right here, which is a little bit worrisome, given that you'd be shooting down this column. So that means I can't, for example, do this. Because if I do that, then later I'm going to shove the Firefly right here, and it'll shoot you right here. So that's no good. I can light you on fire. We are going to win in 2 turns, so as long as you don't take any extra damage, then that should be okay. That leaves you free to boulder you, and you free to shove you. Is there something I could do better than this? Not really, I think. Yeah, kind of swapping things around doesn't really help, so I think that assignment has to work. And you can go in here, I guess. Sure. And then you'll go over here, I think, and boulder. Alright, so 4 enemies next turn, but the Burrower is injured at least. And we've already met our kill goal. So between the airstrike and our Hermes engine being near the middle, I think we should be able to get this to work, but we'll just have to see. Hopefully the Scorpions go after our Boulder Mech right here, because that would be excellent. That would help waste a lot of time. Alright, this all works out nicely. Yes, this actually works out great. You can take care of them now. You can just get out of the way. And you will be able to step right here and kill this. I could block a shot if I really had to. The shield is nice for that, but thankfully we don't even have to do that. We can just move you, and thanks to that extra step, we can do this. I mean, technically, I guess you needed the XP, but, well, you don't really have anything to do anyway, so just sit there and repair. And you live with 1 HP, which is fine. Alright, nice flying, pilots. you're helping us out a lot in this mission. You, weren't an obstacle at all. You just covered your side of the field and we got the rest. Nice. Yeah, I'm definitely not going to turn down one mech reactor. It's maybe a little bit redundant with what we have, but, it's nice, I guess. Yeah, I'm really tempted to replace this with some other weapon that, we could actually dump more cores into, but of course we don't have any. These, don't exist, as you remember. But something to think about for, the final island, maybe. I don't think... We could swap these, maybe, but... I guess with the Hermes engines, maybe you're the one who wants to be on the front lines more. But... Well, you only have 2 health. Yeah, maybe that does make more sense. Okay, this might actually be a good opportunity to swap the pilots. I'm willing to give that a try. So that means that... Oh yeah, you also have plus 1 mech reactor. So that means that instead of this having 5 health, we're giving it 3 health and preemptive strike, and then you have 2 health and a shield. Which I think makes sense. Okay, we'll see if we can get any use out of preemptive strike. Then again, 5 health is nice too. Let's just take a look and see what our next mission is, then I'll be able to decide. Preemptive strike here would actually be quite nice, with the mines, kind of blocking our field. Being able to deploy somewhere further out here, like right here, actually. Just to the southeast of that city. Maybe tempting some melee enemies to get onto those mines. That could be quite nice. Although, wait, no, preemptive strike destroys mines. Oh, dang. Anti-synergy there. Oh well. Alright, so that's that option. And then if we want to do this one immediately, do we? This is... Not great. Preemptive strike would help a little bit here just for kind of positioning ourselves further up. Could put ourselves between the tanks and damage 2 enemies that way. It's not bad. This is maybe a map where it might be nice to be able to block a shot, but I think we have mostly melee enemies here. Yeah, because we have, like, scorpions, hornets, burrowers, and blobbers, all of which are quote-unquote melee enemies. The only one that doesn't really count is the firefly. And for that, having more than 3 HP is nice. Preemptive strike is mostly kind of like a one-off that helps us get a better turn 1, hopefully. I don't know. It's, I think it would be really annoying if a blob got put in between those 2 tanks, though, so maybe that would be a good reason to take the preemptive strike. Also, preemptive strike, is useless. Well, it's not completely useless, but it's mostly useless if the, regenerator scion shows up on turn 1. And these are both, missions that have 5 enemies, so it's more likely to happen. So, yeah, alright, never mind. I don't know what I was thinking. Preemptive strike. You'll get your time in the sun someday, but not today, I think. So given that, I guess that means we probably just want to put off the high threat mission. Hopefully we can make these mines work for us. Okay, well there's our friend, the frontline scorpion. Can we fool the blobber into shooting onto a mine? That would be really nice. The burrower is probably going to go up here somewhere, hopefully right here, but probably more likely over here. So we probably want to do something like this then. Yeah, Lily Reed will be really nice on this map, actually. Having more, movement points, is really good on a mine map where, you can't usually stop where you want to stop. But this seems pretty good. Yeah. Likely looking blobber shots, could just shoot it onto a mine, which would help us twice. Once, for the blob not doing anything, and once for giving us a place to stand. Okay, great. Hopefully that means the, burrower goes right here, then. Or the blobber can. That suits me, too. Okay, we only have three enemies to deal with, and we've already got a nice 2-for-1 here. So it's really just a question of, do I spend my rocket immediately to get rid of you in one attack? Which I probably do. Like, I love doing that. And then this takes care of itself pretty handily, so sure. Alright. There goes the Burrower, and then, this is not a spawn blocking mission. Okay, it's just a less than 3 grid damage, so for that, we probably just go ahead and boulder you, right? Yeah. Yeah, we might as well keep the shield. There's no reason to bring you up, get hit, and then this would die. So there's no reason to waste the shield on that, just to bring you one square further forward. Alright. Gotta say, we got pretty lucky. I was worried about enemies going down here, but we didn't get that this time. Alright, great. Firefly wasting its shot. Where are you going? Okay. And, alright. Well, we've got options. We could block a spawn at this point. Or we could rocket you and just try and take care of you with one action yet again. And then any kind of a shove will take care of you. So, how do we want to set ourselves up for the next turn? Do we want to rocket? Just get rid of you. It's tempting. Let's see what our options are. So we've got Boulder. Boulder is enough to kill you. You can't kill any... Yes, you can. If you go over here, then you can use your Hermes engines to do this. You know, once this is done. So that might free you up to punch this for 4. So that's one way... Like, that's about as optimal as it gets. Killing this, and doing 4 damage to this. And we save our heavy rocket. That's not bad. That is not bad at all. Alternatively, instead of killing this, we put a boulder here, and we block a spawn with you. Which seems better, because I'd rather deal with a firefly than whatever this is. Yeah, that tracks, I think. No, actually, we can't do that, because... Oh, well, we can, actually. No, we can't, because if I go, if I move you here first, and then I try and, Hermes engines down this way, then I shove you over here, and it doesn't work. It would work with a longer range dash punch, but, not this one. So that means instead we could do something like, boosters this way, or Hermes engine. Then you would go boosters from here to here and shove you over there. And then you would punch probably from here. Yeah, that's also reasonable. So it's just a question of whether I want to do that or not. And honestly, using the rocket to save one action basically seems pretty good. Because that actually kills everything on the board. Yes. Yeah, and then we'll have 3, and that's... I think just getting it down to 3 enemies is worth it. Even if we lose the rocket, I think getting down to 3 enemies makes it all better. And then, yes, we will want to block this. Okay. Seems about right to me. Maybe the Hermes engine can clean you up. We'll see. Alright. Yeah, Hermes engine, you punch you and boulder you. That seems okay. Yeah, because of all of those, you would be the best candidate for that, so... we'll go ahead and do that, then. Yeah, only do this much. We can control how much Hermes engine we get. Yeah, we could block another spawn, but it's not worth it. There's no need to. Alright. And that's kept under control, I hope. Plus, I like that you're a little bit far away from these squares, which are incredibly annoying to deal with. Okay, now there is the classic Firefly in the corner. We can take that hit in two different ways. We can either drive right here, or we can put a boulder right here. Otherwise, you're not a problem, and you can be killed by a boulder. In fact, if I could get you up here, then you could kill it. So here's a nice way we can do that. No, we need... That doesn't work. You need to be... You need to already have been shoved, so no good. So let's not commit to that then. Instead, we'll... Do what? Just trying to see if there's some way I can finagle killing this, but I don't think it's happening, so... then we won't. Alright, good enough. And just a reactor core. Oh well. Was hoping on just getting that free weapon for this mech. I'd take just about anything at this point, but, you know, this is working. Like, our setup is working. I just wouldn't mind having, at this juncture, I wouldn't mind even putting something like a grappling hook or some other hideously expensive ranged weapon on this or some such. Alright, what are we even going to do with another core at this point? More move on the Prime Mech? That wouldn't hurt. I mean, we could have more health on this, but I don't think that's really worth it. Just more move. Then we could do the Destroy the Dam mission. That's pretty reasonable. Not really better odds on this one yet, but hey, maybe we'll get the Time Pod here. And that'll give us a weapon for the, the tank mission. But yeah, might as well do this now. Okay. That's a great spot for the, Firefly. It's going to waste its turn no matter what. It can't reach any, cities. As long as I stand right here, which I'm certainly happy to do. Do not mind doing that at all. Yeah, if we can position our mechs like this, then that should hopefully get the Blobber to waste its turn as well. And then that leaves us free to just do whatever with these guys. For which this ought to be good enough. So, sure, this seems like a fine deployment to me. Maybe we'll blow up the dam early? Blowing up the dam early is a little bit risky when there's hornets on the field and we don't have any flying mechs of our own. So it's still not great. Okay. So we have options here. But most critically we do need to do something to damage the burrower. You can't do it because you're trapped. That does happen every now and then. So probably what we're most likely to do is just rock it, and that is kind of a wasted action to get rid of the shield, but it's worth it. Then, somebody has to deal with this, but we can do that with boosters. And then we could kill both of these fireflies if we, destroy the dam now. We do have options for dealing with the, you know, Alpha Hornet going right here. Mostly in the form of the Hermes engines and or the boosters and or the artillery, so you're kind of disqualified from doing that, which is a bit of a shame, but that's okay. Otherwise, that would leave us... So you would be dead, you would be dead, and you would be dead, and we have destroyed the dam already. Leaving the Blobber alive? Little bit unfortunate that, but I think it's worth it. And of all the places for you to go, probably here is the best. Sure. Yeah, so this seems reasonably efficient. Alright, more or less as I expected. Okay, great. I really thought he was gonna go over here or and attack these cities or something, but, okay, if he wants to waste his turn, it's fine by me. You could go here and block a spawn, and that's probably reasonable. On the other hand, you can actually manage to reach. You can go all the way over here, thanks to the extra step. So we could go here, block a spawn, and shove you into the lake that way instead. Or in fact, you can even zoom all the way across the river and land on the spawn. I think we do want to block one spawn this turn. It's just a question of who's going to do it. And yeah, we can actually finagle it such that we destroy the Burrower again, so I think we might as well. This whole rocketing the Burrowers thing seems to be working out quite well in our favor, so I have no reason to go against that. Now, we could go here and boulder the Alpha Blob, but I don't really want to have all my mechs on the same side of the board. That leaves us too little of coverage if we have an Alpha Hornet that goes over here, for example. So I'd much rather keep my flexibility and do this, because that does two things. One is it puts us over here, and the other is it lights these two forests on fire, so hopefully Hornets don't decide to go here instead. So that should cover things pretty well, I think. Alright, plan for the worst, be happy when you have something better. And yeah, this ought to keep things under control quite nicely. We're going to have a little bit of mech damage here, but that's quite alright. Very worthwhile. Okay. And we're just gonna softball this one, then. Alright, so far so good. But these are the easy ones. Well, we have our choice of single star, single bolt, missions before we want to go to the, go here. We could skip it. Like, we could probably do without that extra core, but, hey, you know, we're taking this, this out on a test drive, and we've already failed our, 30k anyway, so I might as well at least give it a try. And if you can survive the first couple of turns on tanks mission, then it's usually pretty easy to clean up after that, even if you're behind. Like, even if you have five or six enemies on the field, turn three, if you, both of your tanks are still alive, you can usually figure out a way to clean that up, because having five units on the field is so great. But in the meantime, there's no reason to do that yet. Might as well do the Tidal Wave mission. I'd actually like it if we could get the Time Pod to spawn here, because that would, you know, as much of a hassle as it might be to deal with it with the Tidal Wave, I'd much rather deal with it here than on the tanks mission, though. Because that one can get crowded. Can we fool the Blobber into making a bad shot where it would kind of put it up here? Maybe. We can't force that to happen, but we can at least try and make that happen. I don't think we actually have enough places to stand to make that happen, though. Because it's always gonna have, Yeah, it's always going to be able to go, like, here or here, so of all the places for it to put the blob, probably, like, doing this kind of thing is best. Yeah, where would I like the blob to be? Here's not so great. Here's alright, because I can, like, zoom off this way and kind of shove it up here, which is pretty good. And obviously the best place I'd like it to be is, like, up here, but I don't think I can force that to happen. Otherwise, this deployment seems alright. I'd like another way to force the Alpha Hornet to attack two of my mechs, but I don't think I... Like, this is pretty cramped. I don't think I can really do a lot better than this, so it's just a question of being able to respond to the blob, respond to the Firefly, and respond to you. So it is only three attacks, but we want to be efficient. Alright, if I deploy like this, that basically guarantees the blobber puts it there unless the Hornet steals its spot. Yeah, if the Hornet goes right back here into my back ranks, I'm not that happy. So I think it does make sense to put two mechs right here and try and at least put the like Hornet here, here, or any of these spots are decent. Especially like down here, because you can just step around the corner and punch it. So with any luck, that should mean, yeah, nobody should be trying to body block us right here. Unless the Firefly gets any bright ideas, but if it gets right here, we can boulder here, so I think this is fine. Like, I could spend much longer here, but I don't think I'm really going to get much better deployment than I've got here at the moment. And this should avoid some of the most annoying blobber shots, just the average annoyance ones. Well, that's real bad. That's exactly what I was talking about with, Yeah, the time pod on the Tidal Waves map. So we have to get this on the first turn. It will get destroyed otherwise. Other than that... Can I get a nice 2-for-1 here? I think it's hard to do that. We might not be killing the blobber this turn, as I think now this will turn out. We have a pretty obvious combination right here. This works. Then we kind of need to kill this, we kind of need to... Do what exactly? Okay, we do still have the rocket. That is worth keeping in mind. Let's see here. So... The rocket is best if we can get two things to be adjacent to one another. I do see a 2-for-1 here if we can get rid of you, such that you don't crush the pod, or just move you, or something. If we can prevent, basically this move, or, no, this from crushing the pod, then we have a potential nice bit here where this could be shoved up here, and you might be shoved down here, but the Scion's in the way. So that kind of makes, like, three things left to do still, even after that action, which is dealing with you somehow, dealing with you somehow, and dealing with you somehow. And I don't really see any other 2-for-1s in our base kit that could really accomplish that. So I don't think that is the answer. Instead... If I shove you over here, then you shoot the blob. That's another common strategy. So that's a potential gain there. So maybe something like punch you onto that spawn. Run over here to both get the time pod and shove you over there. That'll result in you being here, you being here, you get shot, and then you die blocking the spawn. Or you don't because of the blood sign, so you're at one health. You would also be at one health, because you would be down to one, regenerate to two, block the spawn, down to one again. And then you would have to either boosters or boulder onto this spot. So probably boulder, just so you can stay like right here or something. You're alive in the back ranks and you've shot this. That works out pretty well with you at one health, you at one health, and you still being alive. But the thing is, though, it's not that great because we're blocking two spawns and they're down here. And we're blocking those two spawns on the first turn. And plus, I definitely don't want you to be alive next turn, because if you go down here, it's just really bad. I don't want that at all. So, ideally, if we could come up with a way to kill this Alpha Hornet on the first turn, especially on a water map, that would be excellent. Sadly, I'm not even sure we can do that. So we've got a pretty good first action here. Boosters here will both kill this and shove you over. Then that leaves, kind of the same thing. So that would mean you would, you'd go up here, punch, you'd go... Well, no, we don't want to block these spawns. So that would be something more like this, then. So you would go here and kill this. You would boosters here, and then you need to probably just rocket this. So that means you're alive, you're dead, you're dead. This is dead. So the only thing that's still alive is you and these two. Oh, and you. But we get the time pod, and we kill the blobber at least. Is blocking one spawn good? I don't really see how we would do that, though, so I guess never mind. Okay, I'm just gonna go with the first plan here, because I think it'll work. Alright, last chance to do something else. To block or not to block? I'll try... not blocking. Because that'll result in fewer spawns, and it'll probably work out better for the next turn, I think. We should only have three attacking Vex, so we're pretty well spread out to handle that, so I think we'll be okay. And I do like that the Scion is at least in the corner, so it shouldn't be able to really body block us from doing anything important. Okay, you are probably what I'm going to end up rocketing, although you guys I certainly would like to, I prefer to, but I'm not sure I'm going to be able to do that. Well, never mind, I'm going to get an excellent rocket opportunity right here. So this one we will block, because this will go away next turn. Rocket. We'll go ahead and do this. That makes sense. And then you probably want to... Well, we could kill you, but there's not really any point. Actually, let's block this spawn, because that means we won't have to deal with it next turn either. So that will mean all we'll have is the Hornet and... yeah, the Hornet and... we need to be able to kill you next turn, right? Because, worst case, you're going to go all the way up here into the corner, and that's just yucky. The only way we can guarantee that that does not happen is putting a mech right here. But that means that if you go right here, we don't have great options for that either. And it also restricts your movement quite a bit. Otherwise, we don't really have anything that hits around corners that well. Yeah, that's not great. I'm just trying to think about what do we do about this, because I'm not sure. Like, we can hope that that doesn't happen, but hope is not as effective as a good plan. So if it's at 2 HP, and it goes right here, what do we do? Is the answer, could I have punched you and done less damage to you instead? Because I noticed that the Blood Scion's right here, so I would have been able to bump you into you. And I'm okay with you being still alive if you're dead. Yeah, let's try and reset the turn. just so I can hopefully avoid the worst case scenario. Oh, you're all the way up there. That was the problem. Yeah, so you're definitely not making it all the way down here to punch this, because you were up here last turn. So given that, is there anything better we can do about this? Probably not. In order for you to contribute, you're definitely punching one of these. It's just a question of which. And we're gonna rocket the other, so in that case it just makes sense to do exactly the same thing we already did. And if that's true, then bouldering this is just the best thing we've got. Alright, feels silly to reset and do exactly the same thing I did before the reset, but it happens. It's fine. Alright, what is that Alpha Hornet going to do? Is it going to ruin my day, or is it going to be nice? There's plenty of spots it can fly where I can hit it, and that's one of them for sure. Okay, little bit mean, but we can deal with that. And you're just not even a factor. Okay, you can sneak all the way around here and kill you. That takes care of that problem, frees you up to go here. And you can't really do anything, at least, so just kind of be ineffectual, I guess. Yeah, I don't even see anything funny to do. Oh well. Alright, good enough. If only due to the graces of the Alpha Hornet, but, they're not smart. Like, they don't go off to those, corners on purpose. So I was just basically banking on the fact that it'd see plenty of other reasonable places to go and pick one of them instead. But every now and then, they do get smart, so you gotta watch out for that. Okay, this is something cheap we can stick on you. I don't know if we'll use it, but, it's at least something you can do if, for whatever reason, you're not doing the Sidewinder Fist. You should be Sidewindering Fist every turn, but if not, then at least this is something efficient you can do. Probably if you're doing like a spawn block or something, and you are going to repair anyway, then this is basically replaces your repair action. So what are we fighting again? Goose. That's right. Okay, where is that extra core going? We're kind of running out of spaces to put them. Given all of that, probably the best place is right here, and putting you to 4 health. That makes you, survivable, even if you lose your shield. On the other hand, you can already survive a hit, so maybe putting one more power on you is better? I don't know, being at 4 is rough, and there's plenty of things that can take away that shield. And then being at 2 is rough. So does it make sense to make you more survivable if you're gonna be boostering? Well, you have the boosters to escape from danger, so honestly, it probably is better to put it on you. No. Here. And here. Alright. Well, that's enough finagling around with the power. Let's get to work, shall we? Alright, there's our friend, the frontline Scorpion. Although, really not even that frontline. He's only in rank 2, so could be worse. We'll give him his space. We'll kind of let him pick what he wants to do. If he decides to web one of us, that's not so bad, really, though. Honestly, we might not even want to split this guy first turn. Maybe we just want to try and establish board control. Kill you, and maybe weaken you. Or kill you. Like, killing you now when we have the chance might be better. But of all the people to get webbed, probably you're the best candidate for that. Although we might not even have to settle for that. Like, you have pretty good rank, you can go to whatever, rank you want and kind of zoom if you need to, and you have the rocket, so really, maybe just better not let you get, webbed at all. And then, this is pretty good, especially since you can kind of sneak all the way down here. Not that anything will be going down here, but you have access to this rank at least. Sure. So if the scorpion goes right here, it's not really the end of the world, so we should be okay. Alright, great. Boss is wasting its turn. Happy to see that any day. And are you gonna go right there? I hope you do. Excellent. That gives me a good turn. So given that this happened, does this mean that due to the efficiency of this that I can get started on the boss? Or do I want to finagle? Yeah, you don't have any way of actually getting a clear rocket shot on you. Which is a bit of a shame, but that's alright. Probably maybe just better to kill the Blood Scion now. And not be too aggressive with trying to kill the rest of the enemies. So what does that mean you're doing then? Interestingly, you can go all the way here. I would argue we're not likely to do that, but it is an option. Let's keep that in mind. Okay. So, if we're blocking a spawn this turn, how many would we like to block? That gives us the potential of having a lot of spawns next turn, especially on the same turn we'd want to kill the boss. So I think we really only have two approaches. Either don't block any spawns, and don't split the boss this turn, or block several spawns, and, like, both of them if we can, and hurt the boss this turn. I don't think we can do both. I don't think we can block both and split the boss. This is where I'd really like some multi-target weaponry, but I don't think we're gonna get it. So here's an option. This drives off the Burrower and leaves everybody free to just kind of block spawns and kill the Scion. So then that would mean, for example, you could go all the way over here, block a spawn, and rocket the Alpha Scorpion. And then you would go up here and punch the Scion. So that would leave... Well, you would still be alive, and you would still be alive. You would not. So we'd only have two enemies on the field, four spawns. And then we would also be splitting this. So that doesn't... I don't think the math for that really works out. I don't think it's worth it. So instead, I guess we probably just do want to kill what is there. If I can get you one square forward, then you can rocket this. And I'd prefer to rocket you than to rocket you. Although you web, so maybe it is better to kill you. Because you're easier to at least get rid of, although you certainly need an action to yourself, mostly. We could do this. I mean, that certainly takes care of many things. Then... Hold on. So if we do this, this hits you and lights you on fire. Then if I bump you into you, that gets rid of you and, because you'll have taken one more damage from that. So you'll have taken four damage and be on fire, so you'll die. That'll also, the bump will get rid of you. Then I could punch you. So this would let me do something like this. So we would get one spawn block, the scorpion dead, the burrower frightened away, and you split. So that means we would have you, and two of you. So four enemies and the Scion, which we can kind of deal with. I'm also pretty concerned about enemies getting over here, because we don't really have an excellent answer for that other than to kill them. Although, thanks to the Sidewinder fist, we can actually punch away from this building. That is actually another excellent advantage of the Sidewinder fist, is being able to do this compared to just being able to shove sideways. So, that's nice. So we've got plenty of options, which is at least nice. Like, there's plenty of turns where you just don't have any good options at all. So the fact that I do have this, like, choice of, I have multiple solutions to this first turn, what would I like my second turn to look like? That's at least an advantage. That at least shows that we've managed to upgrade enough, I guess, is kind of what I'm getting at. I do like that first option where we kind of take care of you with the Hermes engines, because that means we can save the rocket for later. And honestly, I think there are plenty of situations where we just want that rocket worse later on. So I'm willing to give that a try. So with that in mind, the correct order of events is, it doesn't matter. You can do it in either order. We just need to make sure that you go last. So, you could even go up here. You could go up there. So I guess if I'm doing that, then I want to do this first. Okay. Then I guess that settles that. I do kind of want to put you upfield because I would like melee enemies to waste their turn if at all possible. And if that's so, then maybe I'd prefer you to be back here after all. Alright, fine. Well, no, you want to be here because... No, if this is a scorpion, then you can only attack you anyway. In that case, just here is better. Alright, fine. But I don't need to take the shot yet, so we'll do this just in case we get a blob right here. We don't, but we could have. Okay, those are fine places for the blobs to be, though. I'd much rather they be up front here than back here. So, worst case is, like, Burrower goes here or here and we have to deal with it, but it should be down to... No, it's gonna have 5 health because it'll regenerate it, but we can rocket it then. Alright, this should work, though. I think we can get one of the blobs to waste its turn. Yeah, because of the fires. Yeah, and you're standing right there. So yeah, I think we've managed to get one of the blobs to waste its turn. Excellent. Yeah, you're taking that spot. You don't have anything productive to do. Excellent. Interesting. Well, I think I know what I would like to do. I'd like to shove you down here so that the Firefly shoots you. But I also want you to be able to rocket this guy, right? So how's this gonna work out? Thankfully you're shielded, so you don't catch fire, which is pretty handy. Yeah, it's only too bad that, the boss goes first, so we can't get you to shoot you. Yeah, I guess that's a... Come to think of it, that's another good advantage of splitting the bosses. The boss being split means that there's more enemies on the field, so we also got fewer spawns. So that actually is nice. That's actually a good incentive to split the boss. Yeah, I definitely don't want to light you on fire. That's just no good. I think that's too early. We can light you on fire later. We just won't do it right now. And then... Yeah, so I just see two reasonable moves here, punching this and boostering this. I'm just wondering what that leaves you to do, really. I mean, boostering into this and lighting it on fire is also pretty decent. Here's a decent move. That gets rid of this problem, and it also puts the blood scion on the spawn to block it. Then we could boulder you instead of boostering. Which is reasonable, I think. I just really want to kill this one, but I don't think I'm seeing any easy way to do that. Okay, so what happens if we reshuffle, actually? So we could do something like rocket this way. So you do this. You take care of the... It'd be really nice to know if this actually splits and puts something on this column, because that would actually be really convenient if that happened. But I think it's pretty unlikely to happen. It could happen, though. We do have a turn reset. Let's find out what our options are first. Let's try this, and if it doesn't work out, we can always reset. And I think that's a worthy thing to spend a reset on, is the blob boss. So we get a... we get a bloblet on fire. Okay, that's good information to know. In that case... in that case, we do a turn reset, and, somebody else kills the blob, but it won't be in this spot. So I don't know if that's guaranteed to happen again. Alright. Actually, wait, oh no, you don't go first. No, that would be too easy. No, no, none of that. You can go up here. I didn't really think of that. That solves a lot of problems. Then I don't have to worry about you at all. I kind of missed that. So we could do this if we want. Then that at least injures you, and you're free to maybe just rocket you. And then you could booster onto this. And light it on fire. Well... basically, to have an easier time killing the remaining medium goo, and also an easier time killing the you, and whatever crops up here. I would like the Blood Scion to die eventually. I'm just not sure if I need to kill it this turn or later. But I did like what happened there when it split there, so I think we do want to commit to that. We're just gonna do that in such a way that nobody gets shot this time. Okay, that's not what happened last time. Was it because I'll have to check the footage. I don't know if I did, like, another action in between. I think in the first timeline I did another action before that happened, or something or other. Or maybe somebody wasn't somebody's standing in a different place than normal, and that's where the blob would have liked to have gone. Something like that. Anyway, I'll take it. I mean, that cleans things up quite nicely. You can go down here, but I'd prefer you not to, because I don't want you to be lit on fire, so that means, we're doing this then. Oh, and frustratingly enough, that means I can't actually put the Blood Scion on the, spawn, so we could rocket the Blood Scion. That's, silly, but I can get away with it, so I might as well, I guess. It's something to do with your turn that's productive. Well, this is not at all how I thought this mission was gonna go, but it's turning out alright. Alright. That's okay. We can deal with that, we can deal with that, and we can deal with that. Especially if you attack the wrong person entirely, that's just excellent all around. So you don't really have anything to do other than punching you. I mean, you could do this. Actually, that's excellent. Let's do that. Then we need a way to finagle basically one damage on you. Sadly... oh, you can rocket. Okay, so we can... in yet more gratuitous rocketing, we can rocket an Alpha Burrower that's at 1 HP, but hey, that does clean up the board quite nicely again, so you would be dead, and you would be split, and we would have, well, we'd have two little blobs and, two of, whatever these are. So, sure. Seems reasonable to me. And then you can... Go where exactly? Here, I guess? So this is gonna die before it shoots this. And then, I guess technically, I should have taken this shot first, just in case a blob spawned here and ruined everything, but thankfully it didn't. So, minor mistake there, but I'm going to be allowed to get away with that one. Alright, so you block a spawn, four enemies left, and two of them are little miniatures. And you are... you're probably going to have to take care of one of these guys, so I just hope that they stick around. This is the only real wrinkle that I'm concerned about, but otherwise I think we're mostly set. I hope that we can use boosters to fix any problems if we... if two enemies are attacking this building, Caddy Corner. But I think between that and the Hermes engines, we should be able to make this work. Alright, great. Only three actions to worry about. Okay, can't rocket you, but that's okay. Alright. Blobber's even gonna waste its turn. Excellent. Doubly excellent. They'll kill each other. So you really have nothing left to do but just kind of shove you out of the way. Yeah, you don't have any damaging attacks left. You can't reach you, so it has to be Boulder. This is the only way to kill you. It's not quite, Alright, here's something cheeky I can do to at least get the last blob killed rather than just merely left alive. So we can do this. Alright, and that's a wrap. The Burrower gets away, which is understandable. 5 HP Burrower on the last turn. But otherwise, we cleaned house. Alright, as far as Island 4s go, that was actually suspiciously smooth. I was expecting things to just go wrong at all corners, but, it worked. Yeah, perfect Island 4. Yeah. We don't really need this, thankfully. I might have thought about it early, but, it's... the fact that it costs one core is really the big, huge slap in the face here, because, you could spend that one core on something that would be much more useful, really. So yeah, we're taking Abe. It's just a question of, where we're putting him. And I guess we're putting him on the charge mech, because I'm not powering preemptive strike. I'd much rather have armored 5 health than anything else. Well, let's just check, see what we can spend our money on first. We're gonna have 3 power cores, right? We could sell the repair drop and buy Gemini missiles for the, specifically for the Prime mech. That would be nice. I mean, this isn't so bad either. It's on class, and, we saw how much I liked that in the other, episode. That's, this is pretty nice. Just for being able to, hit 2 targets at once. I mean, this thing is surprisingly handy, but, if I bought it now, I think I'd only be able to upgrade it, like, turn it on, basically, for 3 cores. So this would only be for 1 use, whereas this I can just keep using as often as I need to, so... and it shoves straight away. This I'm not really gonna dignify with a response, because I don't have the, smoke generator. It is handy, but it just doesn't really fit our build at the moment, and it's kind of awkward to use, and, our brute mech is kind of full up already. And same here. This is a weapon I like. It's a really nice sidearm, but we already have 2 better weapons than it. It's nice and cheap, though. So I think explosive vents is the buy here. We're gonna sell the repair drop, buy the explosive vents, put Abe on the charge mech. Sorry, Ghana. And sell off Ghana. And get 3 reactor cores. Yep. Makes sense. This is just really convenient for being something that you don't have to put a core into. So then that leaves us 3 cores to... right. Here you go. Yep, don't need to... yeah. So 5 health on you still kind of makes sense, especially with the Tyrant Scion, and this... this basically makes sense. Yeah, in fact, this is even maxed out, so... Yeah, 2 damage and a shove on this. Pretty useful. And everything kind of lines up pretty well. Alright, that took a little bit longer than I thought. Despite how well this island went, it was still not really a fast island. But, hey, we actually kept our score above 29,000. That's actually a lot better than I thought we were doing. I thought we were going to be down in the 28,000s for sure. But, hey, we did save a lot of people, so that is cool. Alright, next time, probably a short video to tackle the final mission.